There is some special reason why we are interviewing Mr. Akhil.
Namaskaram. I have started my journey by successfully failing in MCET examination. I joined Ace Engineering College through spot admission. Even though I am lacking fundamentals and everything, they brought me from the core, from the roots to flower in this way. I got a package of 7.75 lakhs in Atlas Copco, which is a core mechanical company. My dream come true.
Okay, Mr. Akhil, when you have seen your MCET result, so your number was not appearing, what were your feelings?
I thought of not to get into this engineering, even though I have fascination for physics. Like I can say, for example, to appreciate music, we need not play music. Like that, I appreciate physics. Even though I am not fit, I thought of going to BSc physics branch. I told to my dad, I am not fit for this. Then he told, don't worry, you can get a seat through spot admission. Let us try. And I went to one of the prominent college. There, he's a really, he insulted me, humiliated me, that getting my, knowing my scores in physics and maths, you are not fit for any of the core branches. Better don't waste your life by joining those like that. I thought, okay, that is my fate, I thought. But my dad was, he never left this. And we came to the Ace Engineering, came to know about the Ace Engineering College, Ace Academy. Okay, we can take the gate coaching and this. I thought this, I put this in my mind and I joined there. And from then, with the guidance of the faculty, from the roots, they have taught me each and every basics that is involved in mechanical engineering. And I am here.
Okay, Mr. Akhil. So, though MCET not qualified, I think you have taken it as a challenge to prove yourself. So, what was your BTEC final percentage?
My final percentage is 67.8.
Okay. You mean to say that to get place in a very good company, certain minimum grades or percentages are essential.
Minimum 60 to 65 is required.
Okay. So every engineering student should keep this in mind. So at least they should have minimum 60%. Okay, right from BTEC first year, how you started?
My journey started with Mr. MP Ramarao Garu. He got to know that I don't know anything, and without any irritation or anything, he explained me what is force. A mechanical engineer must know that what is force. From that, he started explaining me. And with his guidance, I have my fundamentals in engineering mechanics was deep rooted. And I want to share one instance, sir. Okay. Mr. Ramarao, sir, well, in, during a class, it was about to end. He was about to stop the class, but the problem was not ended. That's the solution. We didn't got the solution. Then he told, I will explain you tomorrow, like that. He left the class. Okay, with his motivation, I went home and I worked hard about the problem. I got the solution. Then I went to him that I got this solution, sir. Means, okay, now I have a class. I will catch you up later, he told. I thought he will neglect me. But during the drawing class, engineering drawing class, he came with a book, Calci, and a pen to know the solution.
Okay.
Then I thought to know that he can ask in private. Mm. There is no need to ask in 60 members. Mm. Then the lesson I learned is to learn, we should leave our ego.
Great thing, great thing.
That is the thing I have learned from him.
That is a major problem of the present generation. Even some faculty members, if they lack certain skill set, they don't want to improve. If they attend the classes of some youngsters, maybe in faculty, but knowing better than us, but they don't want to sit. So with this ego, not only the student community, even the faculty fraternity is in fact suffering a lot. So as you rightly pointed out, Ego is the basic enemy for the growth of any individual or any organization. Very good, Akhil. Continue my experiences.
During that, my design, engineering is, mechanical engineering is of three types, design, production and thermal. In design, I got the roots. Then in second year, I admire him a lot, is Mr. Kiran Kumar. Yeah, he a PhD holder, and he explained the thermal sciences in a way I never thought. Okay, this could be this much interested. Okay, and during my intermediate or school days also, I thought studies is something, it's a burden to us. But this faculty made me know the taste. Once you know the taste of it, you won't bunk the class. Bunking of the class is not a crime, but you know the taste, you can enjoy the class very much.
Yes.
From that, I got thermal engineering and fluid mechanics, I got to learn from him. These two are the basic strengths, main strengths for me.
Anyway, what about these aptitude skills, generally verbal and non-verbal skills, which are playing a very crucial role nowadays, majority of placements, maybe on campus or off campus. How you could improve these aptitude skills?
One thing, sir, we should attend our placement cell is really good. They are training us in all these logical reasoning, aptitude and English. If you attend those classes, we can crack this. Software companies or mechanical companies, any company, aptitude is the basic thing. We can crack that. And with that, also we can, with our own interest, we can start searching in the internet, like in YouTube, we can get resources for aptitude. And if you want to be a good mechanical engineer also for this kind of things also, there are beautiful sites like NPTEL.
NPTEL, yes.
You can watch the video lectures from the IIT and faculties. And internationally, also there was a site, edX, EDX, MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and Harvard, they both combined and put that MOOC courses.
As Mr. Akhil rightly pointed out, some of the students may have a feeling that they were not successful in IITG and they couldn't enter into IITs. Or as he rightly pointed out, a foreign top-notch university, MIT. But these top-notch universities are helping the people who are unfortunate to enter into these premier institutes through online courses. It means IITs are at your doorstep. Yes. Great foreign universities like MIT, Stanford, Oxford, whatever it may be, at their doorstep. If you have a willing heart, you can learn from these online courses.
Yes.
See, even though you missed, but still you have an opportunity. As Akhil rightly pointed out, a real passionate, willing student will go through these online courses. See, apart from the faculty available in engineering colleges, you can also taste, as he used the right word, you can taste the fragrance of the beauty of any subject through these online or online courses.
Yes.
With respect to aptitude,
yes.
Have you got any training, whether in the college or outside, design softwares like CATIA or ANSYS like that? Anything you have undergone?
I have undergone training these design softwares in college itself. Okay. Before that, I want to know my youngsters. Young mechanical engineers, that before you go into designing, you should make yourself strong in mathematics.
Very good.
Because engineering is, the stream itself is, we are doing everything is in precise.
Yes.
It's not something they're making up and manufacturing.
Yes. Yes.
The fundamentals must be strong. The mathematic lecturers in our college are really at the top notch, from the differential equations to everything.
Yeah.
It is really great.
Mr. Akhil rightly pointed out. Yes, I got some memory. When I was talking to my son, what he says, suppose in the engineering colleges, particularly majority of the engineering, I don't say all, majority of the engineering colleges in India, suppose there is a robo contest. There is a say contest or automobile contest. What majority of the students are doing, purchasing few
ready-made parts available in the market, assembling, running a car, or running a robo with a sensor. But that is not engineering.
Knowing the science behind it.
Yes, as Akhil rightly pointed out, as in abroad, my son also pointed out, what is the science behind this? What is the mathematics behind this? If you are going for a robo competition, you should know the basic fundamentals about robotics. What is mechatronics involved in it? What are the mathematical principles involved in? What are the design principles involved in it? Four-wheeler. See, if you design this particular four-wheeler, let us say, using a software like CATIA or UniGraphics or whatever it may be, once if you design, and according to this design, if you try to build maybe a model, not a prototype, then that will give you an edge. What is happening? Majority of the students, whether any branch of engineering, in the name of projects, what they do? They purchase some spare parts, they assemble it, they show it. It is of no use. It's a kid's play. Even a kid can manufacture a robo by purchasing few spare parts. As Akhil rightly pointed out, you should know the science behind this. You should know the mathematics behind this. Otherwise, the project is meaningless. Very good point. Even I learned very recently. This is the reason. Now we are also, as engineering college also, going to train our students, all branches. First, the science required for a particular product and the latest software, say for mechanicals, CATIA software we are going to procure. So, science behind, the mathematics behind, majority will think that mathematics is useless, but mathematics is the backbone or the pillar for engineering. Very yes. Good, Mr. Akhil.
Yes.
So, with respect to aptitude, you said, English, you said, what about with respect to soft skills the engineers are supposed to know?
In our English lab is fully equipped with everything. I would like to say that share one thing. Our faculty is not teaching the language, they are teaching the literature.
Okay.
They are showing the taste of the literature. If you know the taste, then you only open the Shakespeare or anything, you start reading those books, those novels and everything, you can get the language very soon. But the importance of literature with the values, everything was I have learned from my faculty.
Yeah, Mr. Akhil says indirectly, I am going to a Chinese proverb. Giving fish to somebody is not a solution, but training those brains to catch fish, that is ultimate. Yes. So, soft skill doesn't mean that it's only English language.
Yeah.
It is the value system, your way of presentation,
yes,
way of dealing the things. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Akhil, very good points you said. So, at the end, nowadays in engineering, particularly, I have seen some videos in Google, etc., social media, several videos now uploaded, now defaming the mechanical engineering. Even yesterday, day before yesterday, I was seeing, I don't know, the guys who are uploading videos with respect to mechanical engineering, just insulting the mechanical engineers. See, our human body cannot survive without even a single part.
Yeah.
See, no engineering is independently able to survive. Just like without a hand, I cannot exist. Without a leg, I cannot exist. But few people, half-knowledge people, are just degrading the mechanical engineering.
Yes.
I think you may also be knowing.
Yes, yes.
As a mechanical engineer, what's your opinion about mechanics? Is it really bad?
First thing is, sir, what you have said is half-knowledge. It's yes. Right. One has to transcend this engineering, sir. I am a mechanical engineer, I am a CSE, something I am easy. They should not be identified with this. We all together are engineers.
Yes.
We are making this world. Coming to the mechanical engineer, everything which you see around, even any mobile or anything, to produce it or to manufacture it, everything involves a mechanical engineer in it.
Yes.
how can they degrade it?
Yes.
The, what I want to say is, you need not take this kind of suggestions from anyone. You can be a great mechanical engineer. It will be possible.
You follow your heart.
Yes.
If you have a passion towards this manufacturing, whatever it may be, so mechanical is one of the best profession. Of course, along with the core mechanical engineering subject, the things required, as he said, mathematics, the science behind, a little bit of design software,
yes,
you should have, and of course soft skills. With these things, I think mechanical is, as rightly pointed out, it's evergreen. As some people are commenting, it was never green. No, mechanical is evergreen, because even I know my son is doing his mechanical engineering. So mechanical engineering is,
yes,
the best, best. You liked it.
Yeah, I liked it. I love
so
it.
So never you felt that
it is yeah,
wasted my life.
Nothing, sir, because it teaches all kinds of, it teaches life. You can sustain in anywhere.
Yes, yes.
And we have to transcend that idea from the college starting only. We should not be identified by I am this, I am that.
Yes.
With that, you are cutting down the possibilities, yes, of being something else.
Yes. So you have to expand. See, apart from core subject, so what are the extra skills required to prove yourself? Maybe soft skills or software skills, etc. See, now I know, so most of the manufacturing companies, recently I said, Boeing, Tesla, Ford, Bosch, many company, world-class multinational companies with mechanical background, you have little bit of software knowledge, and if you have ANSYS or PROE or Creo or some design software, software means not just a peripheral, if you drill dig into it, nobody can match with a mechanical engineer. This is what I have seen. So as a mechanical engineer,
I would like to talk about this software, sir, as yes, you have rightly yes pointed. These softwares are nothing that is different from mechanical engineering. In mechanical engineering, there are many, for example, if you take it to design a chair or anything, we are analyzing its stress, strain and something else, what is required to manufacture that. This we are doing a mathematical analysis, and this analysis is done by a tool kind of any software.
Yes.
That we have to yes think, and
see,
that we have to
remember. Even the meaning of stress and strain, how can you develop a software?
Yes.
See, this is the reason. Nowadays in the manufacturing sector, let it be civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, whatever it may be, these core side engineers are equally placed in the software companies, because finally, what is software? Application of engineering. So, as a mechanical engineer, as Mr. Akhil rightly pointed out, yes, you can create wonders if you are really passionate about
yes
it.
Yes. Yes.
Really, Mr. Akhil, so you proved that nothing is impossible for a willing heart.
Yes.
You
yes
might have really got hurt, H-E-R-T, yeah, hurt, when you were MCET not qualified. When you were not offered a B-Tech seat in some engineering college.
Yeah.
But finally, you proved yourself that you can be. So, a guy might have failed in his life. It doesn't mean that he will be a failure forever. See, failures are the pillars of success. What is required is the eager, the energy or enthusiasm to fight the battles, to prove ourselves that we can. Whenever a negative situation comes, my dear student children, don't react.
Don't react.
Please respond. As the great Gaur Gopal Dasar says, don't react to the situation. Respond to the situation. People may laugh at you when you fail, but the same people will start coming and congratulating you when you are successful. I openly say, when Akhil joined Ace Engineering College, honestly, I was not knowing what was Akhil. After he got placed in Atlas Copco, somebody said, the guy with the highest package in Ace Engineering College is Mr. Akhil, who's not qualified in engineering entrance. Today, I called him for interview. Is it not an achievement? See, what is an achievement? If you are chairman of parent organization calling you, inviting you, and conducting an interview and showing this interview as a role model for the rest of the world, is it not the success? So my dear students, I know several students, they come with tears. Sir, intermediate not qualified, supplementary, BTech supplementary, kya karna, what to do, my life is waste. Beta, nothing is impossible for a willing God. Believe my words, work, work, work. See, in one of recent interviews, one girl said, she attended 44 interviews, but she didn't lose hope. Finally, she got in one multinational company with electrical branch. What it shows? Failures are the pillars of success. Today you may fail, tomorrow you may be the most successful guy. So my dear youth of India, come out of the feeling that if you are failing once, it's not a permanent failure. If not today, tomorrow you will be successful. I want to say one statement. It is of Bhagavad Gita or Quran or the Bible. If God listens to your prayer, He is increasing your faith. If He is delaying, He is testing your patience. If He has denied, there is something better for you. All the best. Thank you, Mr. Akhil.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. God bless.